there. Welcome to the chat here on Thursday, the 2nd of April, 2020. This is joined by me, Joe Wilkes, the second day of April. And of course, we have lots of stuff in store for you. And of course, coming to the end of our second week of broadcasting of the programme. And we've got lots of stuff in store for you. We've got the news from ITV, BBC and Channel 4. And of course, we've got news round as well, where there's lots of stuff to see and look at, and you can also visit their website. And of course, we've got the weather where you are waking up this morning. And then we have a special treat as part of the clapping for the NHS. We have Take That, so don't forget to stay tuned for that. Anyway, now let's catch up with the BBC news from what has been happening overnight and recent. So then, our main headline this morning, the coronavirus has been, and the testing will be unlocking a puzzle, according to the Prime Minister. Testing is the solution to unlock the puzzle of the coronavirus, the Prime Minister Boris Johnson has said, and he was speaking after it was revealed only 2,000 out of some half of a million frontline NHS workers in England had been tested. And of course, you can check more on that. Anyway, yesterday evening, the Prime Minister Boris Johnson posted a video. Take a listen.
I want to bring you up to speed on some of the things that we're doing above all to protect our NHS. And we've shipped just in the last couple of weeks 397 million separate pieces of personal protective equipment to look after our amazing NHS staff, and the Army Reservists and others are doing a quite amazing job of shipping that stuff around the country. We're also massively increasing testing, and I want to say a special word about testing because it is so important, and as I've said for weeks and weeks, this is the way through. This is how we will unlock the coronavirus puzzle. This is how we will defeat it in the end. And what we need to do is massively ramp up not just tests so that you can know whether you've had the disease in the past, the so-called antibody test, because that will enable you to go to work in the confidence that you can't be infected or infectious. Second, people need to know whether they haven't got it, rather than isolating themselves at home for no reason, and that's very, very important above all for our NHS staff. And of course, it's crucial that people who do have the disease are able to be tested positive and to take the necessary steps to isolate at home in the way that I am doing and many, many others are doing as well.
Anyway, that was a speech from Boris Johnson, and we are going to defeat that coronavirus. So anyway, now let's check up what's in store on the ITV news. So then, the coronavirus patients could have treatment withdrawn to save others if hospitals become overwhelmed. The coronavirus patients have their treatment withdrawn and offered to others who are more likely to survive. New guidance for doctors has been warned, so the British Medical Association, the BMA, is the latest ethics advice said health professionals could be forced to make grave decisions should hospitals become overwhelmed with patients. Anyway, you can also check those websites on itv.com/news. Now then, let's catch up from the weather where you are waking up this morning. So anyway, now, like I said, it's time to check out the weather where you are this morning with Des Coleman. Morning, Des.
Hi, great to see you on this Thursday morning. Slight change when it comes to our weather story. We've got a line of showers moving in from the northwest. Not too particularly heavy, but the strength of wind that's pushing them through is around 35 miles an hour. A fairly cloudy day with pockets of sunshine coming through. And in the sunshine, temperatures climbing to 14 degrees.
Thank you very much, Des. You can also check that on the itv.com/news. Anyway, we'll be back We'll be back later on. We will continue later on with more on those updates on that coronavirus and the special guest performance by Take That with Rule the World. Now it's time to join the team in News Round to see what they've got in store for you. So anyway, now it's time to hand over to News Round with the new presenter, Shaniqua. Over to you, Shaniqua. Hello again, welcome back. Now let's catch up on more stories on the Channel 4 from the Channel 4 News. So then, UK coronavirus hospital deaths have been raised by 563 in a day. As government has been urged to increase testing. Anyway, here's this report now from Gary Gibbon.
NHS workers queuing to get checked out for COVID-19 at a testing site set up in Wembley, North London.
And I think all of us, we are given the same time. That's why there was a long queue. But when you reach there, the test doesn't take long.
Many were alerted by email last night. Staff are meant to wait until they have an appointment and a reference number.
Yeah, they said without a confirmation email that you won't get tested. So they're turning away NHS staff now as well. So I don't understand, like, why? What the problem is?
I travel all the way down from Erith, Kent. That's about 2 hours drive down here. And then only to be turned back, that is quite discouraging. I'm not too strong enough, but I just drove myself down here. I don't think I'm going to come back.
At the government's daily press conference, Public Health England said this was the beginning of a much bigger testing rollout for NHS staff.
We will have five centres where people can drive through and get their testing done in order of priority. NHS chief executives.
Anyway, that was a report then from the Channel 4 News, so you can also visit their website. Now let's catch up with the latest updates that's happening around London. So then the updates on the Tube and the DLR. There is special service on the Bakerloo line. There are special services provided on the Bakerloo, Circle, District, DLR, Hammersmith and City, Jubilee, Metropolitan, London Overground, Northern, Piccadilly, TfL Rail, Tram, the Victoria and the Victoria line. Anyway, let's read it out again. So there's special service provided on the Bakerloo District, DLR, Hammersmith and City, Jubilee, London Overground, Metropolitan, Northern, Piccadilly, TfL Rail, Croydon Tram and the Victoria lines. The Waterloo and City and Circle lines are not operating. The Central line is partly suspended. There is no service on the Central line between Marble Arch and Ealing Broadway and Northolt, while TfL are dealing with a trespasser on the track at North Acton, so please make sure that you only travel for essential use. Anyway, that's all the headlines. Now it's time for jukebox time, and today we've got Take That with Rule the World.
You light the skies up above me. A star so bright, you blind me. Yeah. Don't close your eyes. Don't fade away. Don't fade. Yeah, you and me, we
Congratulations to Take That with their song Rule the World. You can always keep listening to their music if you are using YouTube. And anyway, this has been a very successful week. We'll be back tomorrow for more updates on the coronavirus. And of course, we've got Top Loader on the jukebox with their greatest song, Dancing in the Moonlight with a Bit of Stargate. I love them. Anyway, that's about it now. You can stay tuned to watch Loose Women on the ITV. And also, you've got the latest news from later on. But remember tonight, make sure you have a good clap to support with the NHS. Just thank you very much. And it's on air at 8 p.m. and there'll be a special vlog done for that. Anyway, that's about it now. See you all tomorrow. Goodbye.